Lesson 33, Freedom Through Jesus. In today's lesson, we shall learn how Jesus offered freedom to three different people. Jesus proves that he is the Son of God by freeing individuals from the grip of Satan, from the plague of disease, and from the power of death. We shall learn that Jesus alone has the power to release us from these enemies, and we should be so grateful that he is willing to offer liberty to all those who seek him. Our first story of liberty is about a man who was tormented by demons. He had so many demons living within him that he was called Legion, which means a large army. This man was living among the tombs and could not be restrained by chains and went about naked. He was a wild man and could not live among others, so he had to live alone and tormented. When Jesus appeared on the shore, the demon-possessed man saw him coming and went and worshipped him. And the demons within him recognized who he was, saying, "Jesus, Son of the Most High God." It is interesting to note that demons readily recognized the deity of Jesus, while the religious leaders, who witnessed his miracles firsthand, were blind to the identity of Jesus. The demons were very fearful in the presence of Jesus and begged that Jesus would not torment them, but send them into the herd of pigs feeding nearby. Jesus commands the demons to leave the man, and they do enter into the pigs. The pigs run down a steep hill into the lake and drown. When the people of the nearby city heard news of what happened, they came to Jesus and begged him to leave their region. The demon-possessed man, who now was clothed and in his right mind, begged that he could follow Jesus. But Jesus sent him back to his hometown to tell his friends and family what great things God had done for him. He gladly did as Jesus had said, and the people marveled at his testimony. It is often the case that those who have received the greatest deliverance from Satan turn into the greatest servants and evangelists for God, since their hearts are so full of gratitude. The second story is of a man named Jairus who came to Jesus to plead with him to heal his little daughter who was near to death. Jesus agreed to come and heal the girl, but while they were on their way, not only did news come that the girl had already died, but there was another interruption by a woman who also needed Jesus' help. Jairus must have felt rather anxious and desperate, and Jesus told him not to fear but only believe. This second story is interrupted by this woman who comes into the midst of the crowd surrounding Jesus and reaches out to touch the hem of his garment. She had a terrible bleeding disease that could not be healed, and in her desperation to be free from the bleeding problems, she thought to herself that if she could just touch his garment, then she would be healed. She knew that Jesus could heal, and her faith was strong, so she reached out and touched Jesus. Nothing should have seemed strange about this, for Jesus was surrounded by people and many of them were pressing near to him, so he was likely touched by many others as they moved along the road towards Jairus' house. Jesus, however, knew immediately that power had gone out from him to heal, and so he asked who touched him. He asked not because he did not know, but because he wanted to deal with this woman personally and encourage her. Jairus must have been feeling rather anxious by the delay, but he quietly waits for Jesus to finish speaking with the woman. The woman, trembling, came and fell at Jesus' feet and told him the whole truth. Jesus told her that her faith had made her well, and she should go in peace. With such grace and goodness, Jesus healed those who were afflicted. This woman had spent all her money on doctors for the past 12 years, and yet she was only getting worse. Only reaching out in faith to Jesus was able to give her the healing that she needed. It is true for all who are sick with the disease of sin, for we only need to reach out in faith towards Jesus, knowing that through Him our souls may be healed and made right before God. Now we return to the story of Jairus. When Jesus arrived at Jairus' house, the mourners were there and making much noise and commotion with their wailing and flute playing. Jesus asked them why they were making such a commotion when the girl was not dead but only sleeping. The mourners laughed and scorned at Jesus for this, for they knew perfectly well that the girl had died. What Jesus was trying to point out was that this little girl had not experienced a departure from which she would not return. Just as when we close our eyes in sleep and wake the next morning, so this girl had departed, but Jesus was about to bring her back, and so he likened her death to sleep. This picture of death as sleep is seen elsewhere in the scriptures when referring to Christians who have died, for they will once again live in the resurrection. Jesus chased away all the mourners from the house, and then took the parents and three disciples into the room where the girl lay. Jesus took the girl by the hand and said, "Little girl, arise." Immediately the girl rose from her bed and began to walk. The parents and disciples were filled with great amazement at what they had just witnessed. The power of Jesus to release someone from the grip of death is truly a miracle that testifies to his being the author of life. Jesus asked the parents to give the girl something to eat, tending to her needs, and giving the parents something to do to direct their attention. Undoubtedly, they wanted to tell others of this great miracle, but Jesus strictly forbids them from making it known. We have seen today how Jesus demonstrates his power to free people from the grip of Satan, from the despair of disease, and from the fear and power of death. This demonstrates Jesus to be the Son of God with all authority over the spiritual realm, over the physical realm, and holding the power of life and death in his hands. You too can be given freedom through Jesus if you will come as these others did and bow at his feet, reach out in faith, and accept his healing touch. Go home to your friends and tell them what great things the Lord has done for you and how he has had compassion on you. Mark chapter 5, verse 19.